Good selection of impressive toys here. Do you remember Slinkies?
What is it?
Is it an Atari?
Yeah, Atari.
Oh, I never had one of those.
Brings a lot of memories back, all these toys.
Yeah, that whole era. I was a massive fan of F1.
What really got me hooked was going to Donington and watching Senna race there with my dad.
One of his best races ever.
It's nice to see that Pete's got his 80s time in as well.
You're going to struggle with traction.
I'm going to struggle with traction.
There you go, Matt. That's what it used to be like in the old days. You just stick an engine on the back of a tub and it's all fairly simple. But what they've done over the last year within Formula One has just taken it to a whole new level, hasn't it?
It's nice to see some sort of new technology back in F1 with all the new engine and power unit.
It's a huge, interesting engineering task, isn't it? Trying to work out whether you put the compressor and turbine at the back of the power unit, whether somehow you split it and have the compressor at the front and the turbine at the back, where you're going to position radiators so that actually sort of balance out the cooling left to right on the car, which in terms of aerodynamics makes things really quite tricky, doesn't it, Prod?
Aerodynamically, this was actually one of the most efficient planes of its time, and this wing form is one of the most efficient wings you can get. Yeah, you've got the flow coming towards the wing, and the wing's purpose is to divert the flow down, which then makes the wing lift. Obviously, our challenge is to try and get that into our car wrapped around this packaging nightmare.
We've got to turn it upside down.
We've got to turn it upside down.
So it produces downforce, and try and produce as much downforce as we can for the minimum drag.
One of the most obvious changes to Formula One cars for this season is just going to be the look of the cars from the front end with the nose. If you take the regulations from last year, it was an area regulation that we had to adhere to at the tip of the nose, but that didn't extend any further back. This season, they're going to be forced to have a reasonably sensible area progression from the tip of the nose running backwards. The noses will look a little bit more sensible, and actually they'll work better as impact structures.
I must admit that I think our car looks really well packaged this year. I think with the Honda engine we've done a good job.
The chassis is much tighter. Yeah. Honda have done a fantastic job of just trying to package everything into such a tight space.
Yeah. This is a privilege to be at McLaren with McLaren-Honda above the door again.
Honda are just so dedicated to the cause. I think they took it to a new level when back in the 90s, and they're absolutely committed to doing the same again.